Hello, how are you? Today I'm going to try to get into the skin of Janis Joplin. I mean, I know it's going to be difficult because she is an idol. She's a real superstar and to many, many people who adore her. So I wish I will keep most of respect for her because I admire her. And I think she is one of the greatest female voices because she had that very, very personal voice, that slightly broken voice. And I think she was absolutely stunning when she's singing. The soul and the feeling that goes into her singing is incredible. So I admire her and I would like to turn into her and I would like to have her look. She died when she was 27 years old, so I must try to look a bit younger, a bit fresher in the face. And also her hair was very voluminous, it was very frizzy. My hair is more straight, so that will be more or less what I will have to do, the changes I will have to do in me. And I have a lot of 70s style clothes and I will show them to you. Let's get started. Janis had very light brows, so I will dye my eyebrows. If you want to know about how to get your eyebrows to look a bit lighter than what they really are, you can click here in this link and it will take you straight to the video I made about this. Well, I don't know if you noticed, but now my eyebrows are lighter and they are more similar to my natural hair color. So I think they look better on me like that because they usually are too black. Well, Janis used to wear, her signature was her enormous glasses, round glasses, these ones for example. I have got these ones are really 70s glasses. And these I think they are. They are a bit broken and I have mended them a bit. And then I have some other glasses which are smaller than what she usually wore, like this. These ones are more like the John Lennon type. And she also used to wear lots of bracelets. Of these ones are really from the hippie era, from the 70s, 60s. Some were my mother's, some were mine when I was a little girl. So lots of bracelets. She also used to wear lots of rings. The problem is I don't have many rings. So I will have to do the look with less rings that the amount she usually wore. And also she liked taking loads of necklaces. Some of these are also from the 70s, like these ones. Look at these watermelon seeds necklace. Some of them are pretty, some of them are ugly, but they all can go in the look. She used to wear this kind of belt, sequins, fringy, more hippie style belts. She also liked wearing vests. I have some vests here I can use for the look. For example, this one is from the beginning of the 90s, but it's matching the style that she wore, and especially this one, which I bought in Zara many years ago. It's very similar to one she used to wear, though the one she used to wear was shorter. This is quite long, but you know, it gives the look I'm trying to capture. Usually wore some bell-bottom trousers. These are black. She usually wore black trousers and also tank tops. This is a new one. I just bought it. And this kind of stuff. This is really from the 70s. Some stuff I keep from when I was a little girl or when my mother was younger. And also she used to wear sleeves like this. For example, this is matched in hairstyle. And she loved wearing feather boas in her hair. make my hair more wavy and slightly more frizzy, I will use one skew. This is like a metal skew. And I will wrap my hair around the metal skew and pass the this thing, how you call it, the flat iron, over it, so I can get the shape of a very nice a little curl to protect my hair with a hair protectant for this 3M hair heat protectant, or how you say, I don't know how you say, anyway you say, you understand what I mean, you don't you? Be careful not to touch this because it gets very hot. I think it looks nice. I'm not going to do all my hair either, because you know it will take me too long, and I don't have that long to make this transformation. But just a little bit harder. Yeah. Maybe you should only move the flat iron from up down, so this way you don't damage your hair that much. So you lift it and you down. I'm not going to wear really makeup, just enough to make me look slightly younger, which is not easy, but I'll try. So I'll get my, going to conceal most of my blemishes as well. Now I will do my skin, some steeping brush, and my Miracle Touch Max Factor foundation, which I really like. So now I use this Kabuki brush with some powder to set my makeup and make it not so shiny. Some brown mascara to keep it as natural as possible. I will use a little bit of strobe cream on my cheeks, a little bit, just to make them like if I were fresher and younger. And a small hint of Coralista blush to make my cheeks slightly healthier. That's it. Now I'll continue with my hair. So now let's see what I do with my hair. I will, you know, break the little curls I made, so my hair will look frizzier. And I, you see how it looks, huh? I just want frizz in my hair. You know, we usually don't want frizz in our hair, but today I don't want. So I will back comb it and get more volume and more frizz. As you see, it starts to look a bit more like Janis' hair. I think I can start putting my clothes on because I'm running out of time. Try. She used to wear also this kind of thing. Janis used to wear feathers in her hair. I didn't find she used to wear some rose feathers, very light pink feathers. I couldn't find them, but I have these purple ones which could do as well. So Lord, what you buy me, they may set his Benz. My friends all drive Porsches, I must make amends. Work hard all my lifetime, no help from my friends. So Lord, what you buy me, they may set his Benz. That's it. Do you fancy this look?